Yes, okay, thank you. Well, this paper is about, it is about Vaticanus Palatinus Graecus 273, which is considered to be a fragmentary witness to the oldest surviving New Testament catena. And by oldest surviving New Testament catena, I mean the so-called Codex Zacynthius, a palimpsest codex which consists of the Gospel according to Luke, accompanied by a series of exegetical scholia, which are believed to have been copied around the year 700. It is the only New Testament catena manuscript in which both the biblical text and the commentary are written in majuscule script. Scholarship on the text of this catena, however, has been minimal. The reason for this lack of study is the illegibility of much of the text following the palimpsesting of 89 pages from the original manuscript to create a gospel lectionary, copied around the end of the 12th century by the monk Nilos in the monastery of Artamiti on the island of Rhodes. The picture on the slide shows Codex Zacynthius as it stands as now, after the codex in the 12th century was dismembered and the original text was rubbed out and pages were used to make this lectionary manuscript. The faded ink that you can see represents the older writing, which was so thoroughly scraped off that it can only be partially now read, and with great difficulty. It should be noted that when the manuscript was dismembered in the 12th century, the leaves were turned through 90 degrees and the page size therefore reduced. Since the edition of the Gospel text by Dragelis in 1861, Codex Zacynthius has been recognized as one of the most important early witnesses to the Gospel of Luke. A typescript transcription of the portions of the manuscript visible under natural light was produced by Harun Greenlee in 1950-51. Although Greenlee published three short articles also, including a list of corrections to Tragelli's edition of the biblical text, his extensive but incomplete transcription of the catena never saw the light of day. In 2018, a research project at the University of Birmingham, funded by the UK Arts and Humanities Research Council, commissioned a set of multispectral images of Codex Zacynthius as part of the preparation of a digital edition of the entire manuscript. The combination of photographs from three particular wavelengths rendered the undertext significantly more visible than to the naked eye, with the result that the project was able to make a complete, transcription of the surviving pages of the catena. Amongst the outcomes of the Codex Zacynthius project are these two volumes published only a few months ago. The first volume presents the first ever edition of the complete palimpsest. The other writing and the overwriting of Codex Zacynthius. And the second volume contains studies on the manuscript itself in terms of paleography, codicology, contents, structure, the sources used by the compiler of the catena in Codex Zacynthius, as well as on the theological significance of Codex Zacynthius. In addition to this, and working in collaboration with the European Research Council Catena Project, also at the University of Birmingham, the team confirmed Greenlee's observation that the catena of Luke in another manuscript, in Paris Supplement Grec 612, is a later reworking of the catena of Codex Zacynthius. The team was based on the test passages of Luke 10:1-6 used by Carol Linsman and on the examination of 177 of the 215 known manuscripts with a catena on Luke. This analysis identified no further witnesses to either version of this catena. The manuscript, which is the topic of the present paper, that is Palatinus Graecus 273, is only extant in the first two chapters of Luke. In particular, it preserves Luke 1:1-2:35, and so was not detected by this analysis. This paper suggests that Palatinus Graecus and Codex Zacynthius are two witnesses to an individual catena type and cannot longer be considered as codices singuli of catena of Luke. The manuscript with the self-mark Palatinus Graecus 273 in the Bibliotheca Apostolica Vaticana consists of 274 pages of bombastine paper with one leaf of parchment at the back. It is not clear whether it is the work of a single copyist with considerable variation in writing density or more than one hand. There is no colophon or mark of ownership apart from modern library stamps, and the manuscript has been in the Vatican Library since 1623. A full-color digitization was made available online in September 2019. The majority of the manuscript consists of Cyril of Alexandria's expositions of the minor prophets, followed by Theodoret of Cyril's commentary on Hosea. At the beginning and end of the manuscript, however, are the two sets of four pages which transmit the opening part of a catena on Luke, folia 1 to 4 and 271 to 274. The last folio, 275, is a parchment leaf which appears to have been taken from a binding, and it contains part of an exegetical work on Mark 6 written in two columns in a very different hand. The catena pages are very densely written, as you can see on the slide, in frame catena format, as also in Codex Zacynthius, with the biblical text in a small portion of the middle of each opening and commentary in the wide outer margins of each page. The correct sequence of text in Palatinus runs folia 1 to 2, 271 to 274, and 3 to 4. This indicates that these pages were bound in at a later stage. The damage to the current outer folia indicates that these pages have been in this position for a long time. The catena pages have been trimmed slightly, as shown by some of the marginal source indications. This manuscript is described by Stevenson's catalogue of the Palatini Graeci, where it is assigned to the 13th century. Two decades later, Sigenberger mistakenly dated Palatinus to the 15th century, and he also noted similarities between the citations of Titus of Bostra in this manuscript and in Munich Graecus 208, but characterized Palatinus Graecus 207-3 as a late attempt to make a new compilation from other catenae. In his study of Peter of Laodicea, Gauer placed this manuscript in the same overall group as Codex Zacynthius, but he makes no other connection between them, probably because of the lack of an edition of the Codex Zacynthius. Later on, however, in his second edition of Origen on Luke, Gauer connects Palatinus Graecus 207-3 with this Codex Pali Supplementus Graecus 612, the manuscript which has already been mentioned as a later reworking of the Zacynthian catena. The codex is not mentioned in Goy's overview of Lucan Catenae or the first edition of the Clavis Patrum Graecorum. Like Codex Zacynthius, Palatinus Graecus 207-3 was added to the second edition of the CPG among the codices singuli with the siglum 137.5. Although Gauer's later volume on Origen is cited in the description of the manuscript, the CPG reproduces the errors of Sinkenberger, giving the date as 15th century and the final verse in Palatinus as 225 instead of 235, and not making any connection with the catena of the Paris manuscript, which continues to be absent from the CPG. The description of the catena as set petit centardive fails to take into account the fact that the manuscript breaks off in the middle of a scolium and could therefore have covered the whole gospel. About the biblical text in Palatinus Graecus 207-3. The text of Luke is written by the first hand, normally in a slightly larger script, in a separate block whose placing varies considerably. You see, for instance, in this on this slide that the gospel text roughly written is written in the middle of the page. As on this page, the gospel is found towards the bottom of the page. The gospel text is abbreviated through the omission of individual phrases and groups of verses, as noted only around one third of Luke, that is up to 235, is present in Palatinus. The Vatican manuscript does not have the preface found in Codex Zacynthius and only features a list of kefalea for Luke rather than the table of capitula parallela. But in both cases, this list covers the entire gospel, despite the fragmentary nature of both manuscripts. Codex Zacynthius gives out in 1133 and Palatinus, as noted, in 235. Its predominant affiliation is with the majority text, although there are 12 places where it corresponds instead to the editorial text of Neslanda 28. And this table shows the agreements of Palatinus with Nestle Island 28 against the majority text. However, there are four readings which are attested by other manuscripts elsewhere, and along with seven variants which appear to be unique to this manuscript. And this table shows the disagreements of Palatinus from Nestle Island 28 and the majority text. I would like to draw attention to only two of them. There is no obvious motivation for catethen rather than apethen at 123. And the most striking variant is the word kechrismodotimenon in Palatinus. It's written with iota, whereas the correct should be with eta, kechrismodotimenon with eta, for the verse 226, which is a synonym for kechrimatismenon, found in several patristic texts, but not otherwise attested in direct tradition. In terms of the catena, the contents of Codex Zacynthius and Palatinus are almost identical. For Luke, from 1 to 234, Zacynthius transmits a total of 104 complete or partial scholia in this portion of commentary. But there are seven instances where a discontinuity points to the absence of one or more pages. For the same passage, the eight pages of Palatinus Graecus contains 123 scholia. Some of the extracts in Palatinus are preceded by the indication of the source. These are often given in the margin, where some may have been lost through trimming or damage. Where the manuscripts are both extant, they agree in every case except two. There is a marginal scholium in Codex Zacynthius, which is absent from Palatinus, and Palatinus has an additional short extract from Origen, beginning folio 274, verso. It's a scholium between this identified scholium in Zacynthius 61.2 and 62.1. There are also some differences in the division of scholia. In six cases, two scholia in Zacynthius are presented as a single continuous extract in Palatinus. On one occasion, three short scholia in Zacynthius are combined, all of them are from the same source, and one scholio in Codex Zacynthius is split into two in Codex Palatinus. The comparison with Codex Zacynthius shows that Palatinus Graecus contains the full text of six scholia, which are partially extant in Zacynthius. It contains also one additional scholium and 27 new scholia from seven missing pages of Codex Zacynthius. 19 of these are also present in the reworked version of the Zacynthian catena found in the Paris manuscript, Parisinus Supplementus Graecus 612. And four of the new scholia appear in the catena of Luke attributed to Nikitas of Heraclea. In addition, versions of scholia are found in the catena pleaded by Kramer. Regarding the identification of sources in Palatinus, seven of the 10 authors named in Codex Zacynthius are also mentioned in this new scholia. 14 extracts in Palatinus are from Origen, while 13 of these are found in his homilies of Luke. One comment comes from Origen's commentary on John. One scholium is a genuine passage from Victor, also found in Evilon 371, that is the best representative of the catena by Nikitas of Heraclea. Four of the scholia are identified by the copyist as Cyril of Alexandria, and for one particular comment, Palatinus supplies the final line. This is the comment 83.2 in the edition of Codex Zacynthius. Three scholia are attributed to Titus of Vostra. One scholium is correctly assigned to John Chrysostom. The source of one particular extract is given as Eusebius of Caesarea, while the direct tradition of his writings confirms that the latter part of another scholium as well, 22.1, is from the same work. The origin of the earlier part of this scholium cannot be identified, though, and the author of the sole extract identified as ex anepigraphu in Palatinus remains unknown. The remaining seven scholia are connected with Severus of Antioch. Four of them correspond to texts identified as Severus by May, while no parallels can be found for two scholia, that is scholia 28.2 and 34.1. Both are identified as Severus by name in Palatinus. And I would like only to draw attention to one scholium, to scholium 37.1 in Palatinus. It is an interesting case showing different traditions in the transmission of the same text. The title of 37.1 in Palatinus, to aftu apologu rogiota epsilon, that is from sermon 115, matches the detailed information about works of Severus often provided in Codex Zacynthius. In addition, the indication to aftu, that is from the same source, serves as a further indication of Severan authorship, given that the preceding scholium in Palatinus is also from Severus. However, the latter part of scholium 37.1, that is the text that is in red in on the slide, appears in the Catena by Nikitas of Heraclea as part of a comment attributed to Victor. This comment is also included in Palatinus, however, as comment 36.1, without, however, the part that is in red. In the absence of any external confirmation, the exact source is unclear, whether this passage comes from Severus of Antioch or from Victor the presbyter, after all. To sum up, Codex Zacynthius is believed to be the oldest surviving New Testament catena manuscript, preserving a commentary on the Gospel of Luke made up of extracts from early Christian writers. The recent publication of the first complete transcription of the palimpsest based on multispectral images enables new research to be undertaken both on the document and on the text. The present paper shows that Codex Zacynthius is no longer the only witness to this catena. The same compilation for Luke up to 235 is found on four pages at the beginning and end of a 12th century manuscript, namely Vaticanus Palatinus Graecus 207.3. Not only does this new witness assist with the reconstruction of portions of Codex Zacynthius, which are now illegible, but it also provides the text of seven pages of the Catena on Luke, which are missing from Codex Zacynthius. This comprises scholia from seven of the 10 writers cited in this Catena, including Greek extracts from Severus Fadius. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much indeed, Panagiotis. So if you'd like to stop your screen share, we will take some questions, either from people putting their hand up using the action button or writing in the chat. Okay, Christina, would you like to unmute and ask your question?
Thank you very much. I mean, I didn't have so much a question, it's more a comment, and this is just, I mean, this is an extraordinary finding, and I mean, who would have thought that, yeah, we have this solutions to where the text comes from and be able to reconstruct so much. Do you expect to identify more of those texts now or solve even more puzzles? I know it's a bit speculative, but where will this take us?
It's difficult to answer. Most of the manuscripts bearing a catena and Luke has been studied so far. There are some manuscripts, okay, that remains to be studied, but the possibility that we find another witness to the catena of Codex Zacynthius is very low. But who knows, it's a matter of luck sometimes.
It is quite striking, though, that Zacynthius has so often been claimed to be the earliest surviving catena manuscript, and very striking because of its presentation, and yet to find exactly that same catena in a much later, much messier manuscript. And you realise that this huge gap, which we thought there was, is bridged by something surviving in later tradition. And it serves as a very good illustration of why the centiores are not deteriores necessarily in terms of what they preserve. And I suppose in that respect, it's the paratextual feature, isn't it, of the catena itself, rather than the biblical text. It reminds me of the Vulgate manuscripts that have got very early old Latin capitula in them, but were copied in the 10th, 11th centuries, you know, a good 600 or 700 years after those capitula were put together. You could never underestimate what you might find. Are there any other observations or questions about this manuscript or its presentation, or indeed Zacynthius more generally, since with Panagiotis we have somebody who's worked on both the manuscripts? Andy, yes, if you'd like to unmute yourself.
Panagiotis, thank you for your paper and the presentation of this manuscript. I was wondering if the scholia in this manuscript were numbered like the ones in Zacynthius are.
A very small number of them, a very small number of scholia are numbered in this. They don't have the same pattern. We don't have the same pattern as in Codex Zacynthius. The Codex Zacynthius is a more extensive manuscript. It contains up to 1133, catena covering the text up to 1133. But from the four pages that we have from Palatinus, we cannot see the same pattern as in Codex Zacynthius regarding the numbering of the comments.
Great. Thank you. And Joey, yes, one more question if you'd like to unmute yourself.
Thank you. So thank you for the talk. It was wonderful. This is less of a technical question, but what drew your attention to this particular manuscript? Because I know that there are many different catena manuscripts out there, but what led you to this one?
If I understand correctly, because there was some interruption. No, I couldn't hear you very well. But can you repeat that?
Oh, okay. I'll. Yeah, sure. What drew your attention to this particular manuscript?
You refer to Palatinus Graecus 273. Yes.
Yes.
Well. The initial goal was to try to create groupings of all known catena manuscripts on Luke. For this, I chose as a test passage the passage that the Luke 10 1:6, because most of the manuscripts contain the catena up to this point. And because this was also the passage chosen by Karen Glitzman. This manuscript escaped our attention because it was extant only for the first two chapters. At some point, after we have finished with all the other manuscripts, we had also to study those manuscripts that we have left aside. And then, I started transcribing the beginning of the manuscript, and I realized that the scholia there match perfectly with the scholia in Codex Zacynthius. That was significantly important because so far Codex Zacynthius was regarded as the sole representative of a particular type of a catena of Luke. And the fact that we discovered one more witness to this particular type of catena Luke shows that our research on catena manuscript needs to be continued, because I suppose that there are also other, that is that because the CPG has only under the umbrella codices singuli have five manuscripts or six manuscripts, if I remember correctly, it's important to see whether these manuscripts can still be regarded as codices singuli of a catena of Luke, or if these manuscripts belong to a particular type of a catena of Luke. And this can also give us the opportunity to study the genesis of a particular type, or to see the particular connection between the different types, or to see how an old catena like that in Codex Zacynthius relates to other catena, or to try to identify what was the beginning of this tradition, to try to identify how this from where this scholia come from, if there was a particular source behind the creation of this catena or that catena. I don't know if I answered to your question, if I understood it correctly, but.
I suppose that's possibly a good point at which to say we need to put in a word of thanks to our sponsors, because only by having such a big five-year project at which we aim to look over all of the surviving New Testament catena manuscripts, and to try to ensure that we have a way of establishing how they're grouped and they've all been investigated, do we start taking account of these fragments which have been added bit by bit but not properly looked into. And we still have a couple more years to run of the catena project, and you'll see on the homepage some of the discoveries of new catena types, as well as new manuscripts and new additions to the Gregory Arland Lister, which the project has already been able to contribute. And there will be more to come in the remaining months of the project, and indeed you'll hear more about them in this colloquium. But Panagiotis, thank you very much for presenting this important new discovery, both interesting for the biblical text as well as the catena text today. Thanks.